public relations officers in the country met in Kampala for the PROW Symposium, the first of its kind since the association was established 46 years ago. Focus was on good stories, creating reliability and affectability within the profession. During the symposium, it was revealed that lack of an enabling law has exposed public relations officers to a number of ethical challenges.
Practitioners, wherever they are asked to speak on behalf of organizations, to speak out decisions of top management of those organizations, but when actually they have not participated in drawing those decisions. And that poses a challenge to many of them. So we want to have legal recognition so that our practitioners are able to participate in many of these top decision-making meetings.
Now the association seeks to have legal recognition through the PROW Bill that is yet to be tabled on the floor of Parliament. This bill will also help phase out the masqueraders in the profession.
This bill, as I said, is a regulatory bill. It's intended to streamline PR practice in the country, PR training, and promote this profession. Because it's good to do business when you have legal backing. It's a little bit tricky if you start doing business when you're not backed up by the law. So as I said, the bill is intended to give us that legal regime so that PROW is empowered, or the PR profession is empowered more, you know, to deal with the challenges.
The Minister of Information and National Guidance, Chris Waliomunsi, highlighted the need to streamline the profession, just like the lawyers, doctors, and other professions.
I am also aware that you have drafted a bill so that the Public Relations Association of Uganda becomes a creature of law, of legislation, and I want to pledge my support, because I am not only a minister but also a voting member of Parliament, and therefore we shall support you.
The symposium, among others, discussed oppressing issues affecting the public relations sector. Over 500 practicing public relations officers from both private and government agencies attended it. Rachel Nachwala, reporting for the news.